Hey guys, Chris from Provo Beast Audio Insulation, and in today's video we're doing an amplifier and subwoofer in this 2014 Honda Civic. Now in our install here today, we're going to be installing this amp and sub to an existing aftermarket radio. Let's get started. Before we jump into things, a couple of things to note. Our Civic does have the premium audio sound system. However, since we already have an aftermarket radio, we actually are not concerned about that premium audio, as the aftermarket radio already has outputs for our new amplifier. Additionally, our trim level here, we're actually working on the coupe versus the sedan. Shouldn't really make much of a difference in your install, but just so you are aware. Without further ado, let's head over to the bench to show you the parts that we're going to need for our install. All right, so here at the bench, the parts that we're going with in our install today is this Scar Audio base package that the customer wants us to install. Included in this package is this 1200 watt amplifier. It does 1200 watts at 1 ohm. And the subs that we're pairing this to that came with the kit are already in the trunk, but these are the SDR 10-inch Scar Audio subwoofers in a Scar Audio ported box. Also included in this kit is a 4-gauge OFC amplifier wiring kit, which basically almost includes everything that you'll need for your install. Now finally here, whether you have the factory radio or not, we actually have an aftermarket radio, so we don't need a lineout converter. But if you are running the factory radio, whether you have the factory amplifier or not, this is a great solution. A step up from this would be the audio control LC2i for bass roll-off, but this essentially will take your speaker level signal, produce an RCA output for your amplifier, and also can generate a remote turn on for you as well. If you have the factory subwoofer that's in the rear deck, you'd want to hook this up to that factory sub. If you don't have the factory sub, you can tap into really any speaker wire within the vehicle. So at this point of time, what we're going to do is plan on installing this amp underneath the driver's side front seat. Plenty of space there. There's no vent. It's a great place for an amplifier, and we're going to start running a little bit of wiring. Now in our wiring kit comes with power wire, we have some ground wire, a remote turn on wire, RCAs, and sub speaker output wire. Comes with a little bit of split loom and a fuse and fuse holder. This will need to connect to our battery here, and we want the fuse as close to the battery as possible in that line. Ground, we're going to go to a factory grounding location located underneath the seat. Your RCAs and remote turn-on wire will need to go between your radio and your aftermarket amplifier. Now, if you don't have an aftermarket radio with RCA outputs, again, this will connect into the line-out converter instead. And then this will have to run all the way to the trunk area. So let's go ahead and grab our amplifier and start. Now we have a 12 by 16 inch piece of ABS plastic that we've kind of cut into this L shape here. It's going to butt up against one of the seat mounts, and then this will fit in the perfect location up underneath the driver's side front seat. We mounted our amplifier to this, which is great. And then we'll tack the carpet. It's not going to go anywhere. It's a great location. So we're going to make as many connections to the amplifier here at the bench as possible. And then we'll head to the car to start pulling our power wire through the firewall. Now underneath the hood here, our battery is located on the driver's side front corner of the engine bay. Under that red cap is going to be where we're going to be connecting our power wire to the stud found at that spot. We'll find a good place to mount our fuse holder somewhere here in the engine bay, and then we got to run our wire through the firewall to the driver's side front seat area. Looking at the vehicle, there's a big grommet on this side and a big grommet on this side. This side's a lot tighter because we have the airbox, brake fluid reservoir. So it may be better in your interest here to actually run your wire over to that other grommet. There's a lot more space to pierce through, run your wiring. We are actually gonna still stay on the driver's side. The grommet is located at the kind of the kick panel at the driver's side area. What we've already done is pulled a hanger through that grommet. We basically pierced through it, ran our hanger, grabbed it from this side, and we're gonna use this hanger to fish and feed our wire through this tight area, through that grommet into the cabin of the car. All right, so we cleaned up the paint really well there with a wire brush. We took that factory ground off. Now, before we did so, it's always a great idea to remove the negative off the battery, just in case that's tied to any safety features or anything in the vehicle needed. We don't want to trip any warning signs or sensors within the car. So now we're going to get our amplifier mounted and hooked up to that grounding location for our amplifier ground. Right, so we're here at the bench. We have wired up as much as possible here at the bench before we have to get it in place. We hooked up our ground here, put a wire ferrule on, got it all nice and heat shrink. That's good to go. That'll go to a factory ground location, which we'll show you how to install here in a moment. Speaker wire output, we're going to run two runs. Even though it's a mono, it has two speaker outputs, which is great. And we went ahead and actually got that all nice and mounted. We have holes here so we can zip tie our wiring to the board once we get it in place. We got to hook up our RCAs and a remote turner wire and the power wire still. So we're not fully zip tied and ready to go, but we will once we get this installed in the car. All right, so we're here in the car. Now we need to, at this point of time, hook up our RCA cables and a remote turn on wire from the outputs of our radio and send those to our new aftermarket amplifier. Now we have the radio out. Obviously you didn't see us do that in this video because we already covered that in great detail when we did a radio replacement on this generation Civic. We're going to link that video down in the description, which walks you through step by step on radio removal and radio install with an aftermarket unit. So with the radio on out, we have our remote turn on wire and our RCA cables here. What I've done is I've just taped them every 6 inches or so because they're going to the same location. Now what we're going to do with this radio on out is, being that the amplifier is going to be mounted under the driver's side seat, we're going to fish it down, kind of down by the gas pedal there, and then we're going to go along the center console, working our way towards the underside of the driver's seat. So let's go ahead and fish these in. So with that now fished through, let's hook up our remote turn-on wire to our radio's remote turn-on wire. We happen to be doing a Pioneer here today. Pioneer's remote turn-on wire is blue-white. If your radio doesn't have a remote turn-on wire, you can also tap into the accessory red wire of the aftermarket radio harness. Plug that on in here. We'll crimp in. Now you saw us run our RCAs and remote turn-on wire from the radio cavity and down, and we're going to fish that up underneath the carpet from the center console way, and we're going to feed it into the RCA inputs and the remote turn-on wire here on the amplifier. We'll put a wire ferrule, just like we did also on these wires, on our remote turn-on wire, just so everything is nice and crimped and ready to go. And really at this point in time, we're done here at the bench. Let's head back to the car to start getting everything wired up. Alrighty, so we went ahead and got our amplifier all in. Everything's all zip tied and mounted. It's nice and sturdy. It's not gonna slip around or go anywhere there. With that there, we purposely put our terminals on this side here so we can make all our adjustments once the amplifier was installed. We'll need to set our gains here. We've got everything zip tied. This wire here is LEDs. This is not ours, but all zip tied. We ran our speaker wire back. It just made it to this point. We still need to fish it into the trunk area. But base knob and the power cable go this way. It's all zip tied along the factory loom. So we can basically get everything all reassembled here. We fished our RCAs and remote turn-on wire up underneath the carpet there, came out there into the terminal of the amp, and we'll show you how we did that. We just popped that up to give us the space and access we need to fish it under the carpet. With the ground all done, with all our terminals now hooked up here on the amplifier and in place besides tuning, we can actually go ahead and reassemble a lot of the panels in this position. RCA's remote turn-on wire, when they were hanging down here after we fed them through the dash, we actually just popped this on up. Just held on with clips here so we could run our RCA's and remote turn-on wire right down through that channel. Then we went down up underneath the carpet there, which gave us access to feed it up underneath to the amplifier. So that's how we did from the radio, fish it down through the center console, up underneath the carpet to the amp. So here in the engine bay, with our wire was pulled through the firewall. Now we actually just ran it down here. We split loomed it all the way back to where it passes through the grommet. We actually went up and around the battery all split loomed, and we put our fuse holder right there. It's sandwiched with extra ABS from our amp mount. It's sandwiched underneath the battery bracket. It's not obviously screwed into the battery, but it's fully serviceable, but yet it's also mounted there. It's a nice location. You can also make one that hangs off and snag a bolt there. But this is a great location here with really flat flush screws that hold itself into the ABS piece of plastic. And then we have a short lead that goes right to the positive post there on the battery. Obviously, everything was done here with the negative off the battery during this install. But since now everything's now connected, we can put the negative back on the battery and go ahead and start our tuning. Okay, so we finished wiring up the Amplifier, got our gains all set. The LEDs are going because the car is running. Yeah, it's all in there. It's all nice and cleaned up here. Got our crossovers all set up as well. And at this point of time, we're just about done with this install. Since the amp's all tuned, we can go ahead and bolt the seat back up. All right, so we got our subwoofers all hooked up there. We got the box all hooked up to the terminal cup there. And really, that is it for this install with the negative back on the battery. We went ahead and got everything tuned, mounted our seat back up, and that's about it for this install. So if you have any questions on what we did here, go ahead and post a comment below. Also, if you want to pick up any of the parts that we used here today, go ahead and check the description. We'll have a link there for your convenience. Thanks again for watching. Again, if you want to see any other installs on our Civic line, go ahead and check the description. We'll link those videos there as well. Be sure to hit the like button if you like what you saw. And don't forget to subscribe. We post great content on the channel all the time, and we will see you in the next video.